The Buddha, at the time of Lord Buddha, he dwelt on this earth 45 years as a Buddha. Wherever, whenever he dwelt, Sarvasti or Vilivana or Nikjararama or anywhere, whenever he dwelt, he lived. Three times in the day, three times at night, he observed the whole world. What is happening in the world today? Evaluate one time in the midday, in the sunset. What is happening in the world today? Very early night, at the first watch of the night, observe and study. Look what is happening in the world today. The midnight, in the early morning, before the sunrise, also observe what is happening in the world today. So, 24 hours in a day, Buddha observed the whole world, what is happening in the world today. Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to encourage you also. At least like a Buddha, six times in a day, you should observe yourself from feet to head, from head to feet. What is happening in my own world today? It is better every moment, every hour, you should observe from feet to head, from head to feet. What is happening in the world? In my own world, in this moment. But all of human beings never observe their own world. They are observing, they are studying, they are looking. They are evaluating outside world only. Most important then to study, to observe internal world. If you look outside the world, Australia, Asia, Europe, America, all human world, animal world, even the world of a deity, Supreme Deity, spirit world, any living being world. When you study, when you observe, you will see Sapo Loko Pakampito set by the Buddha himself. Sapo Loko Pakampito, the whole world is shaken momentarily, like an earthquake. The whole world, human world, animal world, ေးရှားဝယူရိုဝအမေရိကဝ anyone economic war political war religious war anyone never stable nothing they have stability always shaken moving like a water in the ocean like an earthquake always shaken stumbling nothing stability Therefore, I'd like to ask all of you, my dear brothers and sisters, in this unstable world, shaking world, you must try to stabilize yourself. A stunning world, momently shaken, momentarily unstable, like an earthquake. In the same way, internal war, from your own war, from head to head. If you do look at deeper and deeper, you will see momentarily shaken, unstable. As long as you cannot control this unstable war, you cannot find out any peace and happiness. This is the nature of the world. Said by Buddha himself, Sabbo loko pakampito. Sabbo loko, the whole world, pakampito, shaken and unstable. As long as we cannot train ourselves to be stabilized, we cannot attain the peace and happiness. And then Buddha said again, when he observed the whole world 6 times in a day, he saw another nature of the world. Sabbo loko adipito. The whole world is a sapoloko pachalito. Sapoloko pachalito. The whole world is burning, blazing, like a wildfire, forest fire. Always a burning. Human war, animal war, deity war, the whole world of all living beings, momentarily, continuously, successively, burning like a forest fire. The fire of desire, the fire of hatred, the fire of delusion, the fire of anger, the fire of jealousy, the fire of competition, the fire of wrong view. Oh, 11 kinds of fire. Blazing the whole world. But nobody knew I am in the burning of fire. Nobody knew. This is because of ignorance. But someday, most of the people, I think all of the people, even they are in the burning of fire. They are so happy, like Indian people. Some of Indian people like very much the chili. In the mid of summer, Very poor workers are working on the road, road construction. At the time of lunch, they prepare their lunch. Look at their lunch. Just a plain rice, just water and salt and chili. They put the water into the rice and they put the salt into the rice and mix it and eat it very enjoyably. And then eating the chili. The outside, the sun also burning over 110 Fahrenheit. No shade on the road, they are eating. And the looking for the chili up one after another, and eating and looking and bringing some after another. Someone said, "Hey, Mrs. and Mr. Indian, what are you looking for? The whole body is become red, sweat also flow down like a rain and water, but looking for the chili one after another. What are you looking for?" "I'm a son looking for the some sweet of the chili." Really, ignoring it, very wonderful. They are burning internally, externally, but they are searching for the chili, looking for the chili, eating the chili. In the same way, everyone burning internally, the fire of defilement, kilesa. Externally, fire of a sensual pleasure, internally or externally burning, but they are looking for such a kind of sensual pleasure which is burning fire only. This is ignorance. Ignorance and thirsty craving, it is a source of all kind of suffering. So Buddha expounded second stanza, sappo loko pachalito. The whole world is burning internally and externally. The sappo loko adipito. The whole world is burning internally. Two kinds of fire. External burning means the defilements are because of sensual pleasure. Internal burning, raga, dosa, and moha. So Buddha says, sappo loko pakkambito, the whole world is unstable and shaken. They cannot survive in stability. The whole world is burning internally, externally. They cannot find out the peace and happy. But all of our peoples are happy in this burning world, in this unstable world. Buddha observes six times every day. All of our media, brothers, sister, please observe yourself from feet to head, from head to feet. In this very fatalong war, fatalong war. What is happening in this moment? Meditation is nothing but observing the present moment in this physical mental world. Just observe what is happening in this present moment. In this sutra, Buddha said only three stanzas. Sapoloko, Pakambito. The whole world is shaken, moving, unstable. You should observe your mental and physical body in this very path of law. What is happening in this moment? You will see unstable, unstable, shaken, shaken, moving, moving, running. Like the water flowing in the river non-stop. And the second, you should observe whether you are physical, mental body from feet to head, what is happening? Burning, 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 blazing, like a forest of fire. Every moment you should forest fire. Everyone cannot attain, cannot achieve peace, happiness at any time, anywhere. In the Buddha's dispensation, we have technique. We have technique which is said by the Buddha himself. The Dhamma. Dhamma is a very powerful to stabilize in this unstable world. Dhamma is a very powerful to diagnose such kind of burning, blazing fire in this external internet war. Buddhism is nothing but it is a Dhamma. Dhamma in religion is very different. In religion, believe in God. Just a mere belief, nothing affected and you are burning war. Unstable world. Worship to the God. Just a mere worship. Nothing you will achieve. Prayer under the God. These three things are dealt mainly with in religion. If you are sick because of some disease. You go to the doctor, show and see, I'm sick, I'm ill. The doctor take out many equipment, test after test, using the many equipment. Write down on the paper, many prescription. Many prescription write down on the paper, but only two, don't and do. And he will give you many medicine, many tablets of the medicine. You bring him back, including the prescription. When you arrive back in your home, you read out this paper. Very wonderful paper written by the specialist doctor. Very good prescription. Written again and again. Given the medicine also. Very powerful medicine, made in USA. Very good. But just reading, just pray the doctor. If you don't take any medicine, you're going to die. Nowadays, all of religious worshippers don't like this patient. Reading the prescription, believe in the Tao Te, read in the prescription, worship the Tao Te, priya the Tao Te. Just read in the paper, never take the medicine. Most of the people in the world today just superficial, like this patient. Never take the medicine. Our Lord Buddha looked like a great physician. Within 45 years, he taught 3 Pitaka, Sutra, Vinaya, and Abhidhamma. Sutra mentioned, in the sutra mentioned many techniques how to dine out such a kind of fire, how to civilize this shaken world. Many, many, many techniques mentioned in the sutra. Vinaya is the discipline, not to do any evil, not to speak any evil. Many different kind of disciplines are mentioned in the Vinaya. Abhidhamma. Abhidhamma is a nature of your physical, mental body, from head to head, within this very featherlong body. What kind of a materiality, what kind of a consciousness, how many kind of a mental states are combine, come in, join it together systematically. Abhidhamma is the nature of a mental, physical body. So this is a 3 Pitaka, meaning it is a prescription. You should believe in the great physician who is the Buddha. You should read the prescription, but without taking the medicine, you are so stupid. What is the medicine here? Sila, Samadhi, and Panya. These are 3 things are your medicine. Sila, discipline to control your body and your speech. Your body, physical body, in the your physical body, bodily action and verbal action. In this physical body, verbal action, mental action, always unstable, always burning, because of doing the evil, speaking the evil. You are always in the burning fire. Evil deed, evil speech are really burning fire in this world, in the mind. Your mind always thinking evil. The thought of a sensual pleasure, the thought of ill will, the thought of covetousness, the thought of jealousy, the thought of wrong view, all of evil thoughts are your mental fire. In your mind, such kind of fire, how to die now? Samadhi is very powerful. This is a mental discipline, not to think any evil. Mental fire gradually die now, under the power of mental discipline. This is a medicine which is the usual eat. And the Panya, higher stage in Buddha's teaching, Panya. Sila, primary state in Buddha's teaching, to control your bodily fire and verbal fire. Samadhi, second stage in Buddha's teaching, to control mental fire, upper level fire of your mind, not inner level. If you can control your mind on a single object, your mental fire gradually dies down. You can control your mental fire. You'll have the mental peace, mental happiness. This is the second stage of medicine and Buddha's teaching. It is not sectarianism. It is not a religion. Religion and Dhamma is very, very, very different. Religion for belief, religion for worship, religion for prayer, Dhamma for learning and practice and understanding. Very different. Today in the world, most of the people are only religious worshippers. Therefore, they cannot find out their stability, their peace, their happiness. They are always running in the burning. Highest state in Buddha's teaching, Panya. Primarily, I would like to introduce what does a panya means. Pakari na janadi di panya. This is a Buddha's word, Buddha's language. Pakari na janadi means, please try to understand in detail what I am. You are always in tokens. You always said, I am a human being. What is a human being? What is an animal? Please try to understand in detail. It is very important. As long as you cannot understand in detail what I am, you cannot remove your ignorance, thus degrading a wrong view. As long as you cannot remove such a kind of impurity and negativity, you will be burning, running again and again. You cannot attain any stability of the life. The source of instability, the source of burning fire is ignorance, impurity, and negativity. So to remove such kind of impurity and negativity, we must learn the panya. We must learn our own education within ourselves. Now you are sitting in this Dhamma hall. What is this building? You will say Dhamma hall. Because teacher talking the Dhamma, students are learning the Dhamma. Therefore, this is a Dhamma hall. If Buddhist monks living permanently here, change the name. No Dhamma hall, monastery. If husband and wife living here permanently, change the name. This is a house. If king and queen come and live here, change the name. Royal palace. If animals that come and live here, you should put all kind of animals, change the name, the zoo. What is the realistic nature? What is the reality of this building? Not Dhamma hall, not monastery. This is not a house, not royal palace, no shrine. Actual meaning of this building, only wood, iron and brick. These three things that come and combine systematically. Desire, make it desire. Engineer, come and construct. We should understand how many material things that come and combine. Brick, iron, wood. And the same way, from feet to head, from head to feet in this very fathomless body, what I am, investigated wisdom is very powerful in the insight meditation. You should investigate like a Buddha. Buddha investigate 6 times every day. What is happening in the world? What is the world? We should investigate ourselves. We should observe ourselves. What I am, like this building, in this very featherlong body, citta, citta-sika, and rupa, mind, mental state, and materiality. Three things are systematically constructed by your engineer. You are engineers, you are karma. Desire. This is human desire. Very different from animal. Animal design also different from human design. Desire is a designer. So we must understand. Who made this design? Your desire. Who constructed this design? This physical mental body, karma. So karma and kilesa. Kilesa and karma. This is the designer and constructor. Oh, we have to learn many things about ourselves, what I am. Mental body, how many mind, how many consciousness, mental state, how many kinds of mental state, materiality, how many material quality within ourselves. Buddha observed the outside world 6 times in a day. I would like to ask all of my dear brother, please observe, please investigate within your own world at least 6 times in a day. What is happening? What I am? This is the basic principle of the Panya wisdom. So Buddhism and religion is very, very different. Religion just mere belief, worship, and prayer. God-centered teaching. It is called theocentric teaching. And Buddha's teaching, Shila, just control your body and speech. Samadhi, just control your mental activity. Panya, just observe what I am. Sila, Samadhi, Panya. This is Dhamma. Dhamma, human-centered teaching. Therefore, this is a difference between religion and Buddhism. Buddhism is a human-centered teaching. But in the technical term, we say homocentric teaching. Homocentric teaching means human-centered teaching. Buddha very good human value. And religion, well regard, best regard, and the value of the God, God-centered teaching. Ladies and gentlemen, this is a difference between Buddhism and religion. You are, we are very fortunate because we have very good education system to learn ourselves what I am. In religion, to learn the Theo. Theo means a God. So ladies and gentlemen, Buddha observed 6 times every day what is happening in the world. Buddha saw only here, today, I contribute only 3 things. The whole world is unstable and shaken every moment. The whole world is burning internally and externally. In the same way, you should observe yourself every moment, not only the 6 times, but every moment. Observe yourself from feet to head in this very feather long body. What is happening? What I am? Please try to study. In the conclusion, no? When you study within your physical body and mental body, you will see always a shaking and moving and uncontrollable action, bodily action to do evil, verbal action to speak evil, very difficult to control. But we have technique to control such kind of evil deed, evil speech, evil thought. Sila is very powerful principle, very powerful discipline to control your bodily action from evil deed to good deed. We have technique to control verbal action from evil speech to good speeches. We have another higher technique to control our mental activity from evil thought to good thought. Oh, this is a Buddhist conversion, not religious conversion. Religious conversion is very clear. From Buddhist to Christian to Buddhist, conversion, go to the churches. Go to the Buddhist shrine, go to the mosque. This religious conversion, it is a superficial. You should try to convert yourself from evil to good. Under the power of a sila, you can convert your deed, your speech, from evil deed to good deed, from evil speech to good speech. Under the control of samadhi, you can convert your mind from evil thought to good thought. Under very powerful wisdom, you can control your understanding from wrong understanding to right understanding, samadhi. Samadhi, right understanding. When you achieve such a kind of rightly understanding what I am, this right understanding leading to the Nibbana. Samadhi, Bhikkhave, Nibbana, Nina, said by the Buddha himself. Rightly understand ourselves It is leading to the Nibbana. Completely stability, completely peaceful, all fire totally died out. May all of you lead yourself to totally stability and totally peace. Thank you very much.
Yeah, be a qua, chen da ja ba.